Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Robert Rodriguez, and today I am joined by...
the one and only slightly injured Smack Daddy in the corner.
Slightly injured? Are you okay, sir?
My throat is ruined from yesterday's game of Scotland and USA, unfortunately.
That was a very loud match, I can definitely understand. So today we are here to see the second final of the day for the plate, which is Team Wales versus Team Australia.
I think the teams are just lining up now. They're going to get to their national anthems in just a moment.
The first national anthem will be for Team Australia. Everybody here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup has been extremely respectful. They've been standing for all their national anthems. We invite you to do so at home as well. We're just still waiting for ref checks to be completed. So while we're there, let's meet our two teams. So for Team Australia, we have skater number 0, Skate Pilgrim. Skater number 1-1, Sausage Rolls. Skater number 1-9-5-7, Spew. Skater number 2-7, Yamam. Skater number 4-7, Rogan Josh. Skater number 505, Son of Skating. Skater number 5-7, AJ Stevens. Skating number 7-5, Just Incredible. Skating number 7-7, Bohemian Slapsody. I'm going under today as Richie. Skating number 8-0, Flaming Galar. Skating number 8-8, Monkey Nuts. Skating number 8-9, Trinder. Skating number E-1-1, Rampage. And skating number F-E-3-C, Fuzz.
Looks like the Team Wales guys are now taking to the track. And think they're just trying to clarify what's going on before they get into the the national anthems. We'll hang fire on giving you the Team Wales roster until they just get this cleared up. There we go. They've got it. They're just so keen to get underway.
Definitely, this game cannot wait to happen.
It's a massive game.
Okay, so we'll come back at you after these anthems. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Australia.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Those two national anthems you just heard were for Team Wales, Hen Lad Vanadai, and for Team Australia, Advance Australia Fair. I hope I get extra Welsh points for pronouncing those correctly.
I think you fully deserve them, Cody. Right, we'll move on. We'll give you a rundown now on the Team Wales lineup for today. Number one is Manwaring. 117 is Roll Call. Number 17, Jenkins. 218, 218 is Longworth. 254, Jones. Number 26, Swift. 28, 28 is Ashton. 2x4, Creighton Griffiths. Number 3, Hayes. 36, Phillips. 43, Clark. 79, The Mechanic. FE26, Meredith. And HK86, Clements.
And in the time it took for that one, we've already had our first jam. It was Jones going up against Sausage Rolls. And it was Jones that got lead jammer and called off the jam instantly. In this next one, we have The Mechanic 79 going up against Skate Pilgrim, number 0 for Australia.
Number 79, The Mechanic, wants to say hello to Sarah back home as well, who's more than likely watching in with the kids just now. He says he'll be home soon.
Skate Pilgrim and The Mechanic working at the back of the Australian wall.
Mechanic doing what he does best, spots a gap down the inside, quick feet, jumps onto one skate, laterals round and takes lead jammer for Team Wales.
And no pass, no penalty for Skate Pilgrim as he comes through in his initial pass.
Mechanic's already approached the back of the Team Australia line. He clears round the outside, skating backwards, puts 4 points on the board for Team Wales and calls the jam off.
Back on the jammer line for Team Australia, we have Sausage Rolls going up against Meredith for Team Wales.
Meredith skated extremely well in their game earlier against Scotland to get themselves to this final. Be interesting to see if he can keep the momentum going that he had in that game. Meredith takes off as quickly as he can, but straight into the back of a solid Team Australia wall. Doesn't make a difference to him. Sees that hole on the inside line. Goes past like there's no one there.
He really did seize the opportunity on that inside line. He's now coming round for the back of the wall. Slips round on the outside.
Changes his mind. Inside to take lead, outside to get the points. 3 points on the board for Meredith. Quick switch around for probably who has been undoubtedly Team Wales' strongest jammer throughout this entire tournament, Ashton. He's small, but he's quick. He drops that shoulder. You can try and clockwise, turn around, face him. It doesn't make a difference. He just charges through and never gives up.
On the jammer line now for Team Australia, Skate Pilgrim going against Ashton, skating number 2828.
Skate Pilgrim just a little step aside to avoid the block from Ashton, but he takes full advantage and takes another lead jammer status for Team Wales.
Team Wales have really been having a lot of success on the inside line so far.
Yeah, it seems to be a tactic that I think they may have worked on in some of their training sessions. Clearly, whatever it is, it's working well for them. But unfortunately for Ashton, as he goes off track, he tries to force and call off the jam. No such luck. He's called on a cut track, meaning he's now seated in the penalty box.
Of course, this means we have the first power jam of this game going towards Team Australia.
Skate Pilgrim takes full advantage of it and puts a first Grand Slam, 5 points on the board for Team Australia. Oh, strong footwork. He thought again he'd held himself on. Skate Pilgrim this time cuts track on the inside and takes his turn in the penalty box. That does, of course, mean that Ashton's now instantly released straight back into play, and Skate Pilgrim will serve the same amount of time that Ashton did.
And this jam will go for the full 2 minutes. 50 seconds left on this jam clock.
Yep, soon as those two jammers take a seat in the penalty box, no lead jammer left. Don't think it bothers Ashton too much, though. He goes through for another 5 points for Team Wales as their pivot this time is 117. A roll call skates to the penalty box to take his seat.
Ashton having a hard time against the Australian defense. They managed to push him to the outside and bridge him all the way back.
He's recycled about 40 feet back from his own blockers there. He's not going to get any help from them. Skate Pilgrim's back on track now and through for his five. Ashton just coming up against a solid Australia wall. Number 77, Richie, just using his size against Ashton, forces him off to the outside. clock runs out at the end of that one. Three more points on the board, though, for Team Wales there. And another three for Team Australia.
We'd like to take a moment to tell you about Roller Derby City. This jam will be brought to you by Roller Derby City, Europe's largest supplier of roller derby kit and merchandise.
We have had a couple of tweets come through to us. Chaotic has sent to us, go, 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 hashtag Team Wales. And we've also had one through from at a buffet, go Australia, you beautiful bearded bandits. All the bees, they do have some of the best beards in the tournament.
That was some awesome alliteration. So we have Sausage Rolls going up against Jenkins. Jones,
I think he's got through. Jones this time. He tried his hardest, he turns around, skates backward and squares off with Sausage Rolls. No such luck though. Goes for a block, missed, hits the deck and calls the jam.
Fresh to the jammer line, we have Fitz going up against the mechanic. Going against the mechanic.
It's one thing that always gets me with the mechanic. It never looks like that star panty fits his helmet properly, but it never comes off in a jam.
That is something we have been seeing a lot of over the last 2 days here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup.
One other thing we've seen plenty of is Fuzz getting through first and taking lead jammer. He does it again this time for Team Australia.
Fuzz getting met by a strong three wall there.
The mechanic doing what he can, just pushing away at the last two Australia blockers. Forces them out of play, clears through. Fuzz calls the jam after putting four more points on the board for Australia.
So, of course, let's take a quick look at the games that both these teams have played to get here to the plate final. We've had Australia versus Argentina, which was Australia 252 points to 238. And, of course, this morning, Wales versus Scotland, 245 points to 123.
So both teams scoring similar amounts of points in the build-up to this one. Their jammer's obviously doing the work. It's going to be about who can hold their own defence best.
Scott Pilgrim going up against Meredith for Team Wales.
Meredith, he's small, but he just puts that shoulder down and pushes his way through the inside to full effect and takes lead jammer.
Scott Pilgrim was recycled to the back of the pack, but he's edging his way forward now and is through on his initial pass.
Oh, massive hit from Richie. Get out of my way, he says. Richie is a big guy. He's not someone you want to get caught in the path of as he skates toward you. Definitely not facing the wrong direction. Your sternum becomes a target with a bullseye on it, and 9 times out of 10, you'll hit it.
I mean, looking at the size of both these teams, it looks like a classic rugby match.
It does.
So on this next jam, we have Sausage Rolls going up against the mechanic for Team Wales.
Both jammers taking a low start, keeping themselves low in line with the Australia blockers. They come shoulder to shoulder, no one giving an inch.
Very, very dense pack here.
Compact and shut down, but somehow the mechanic found a gap to get through. He takes lead jammer for Team Wales. And Sausage Rolls not far behind him, completes his initial pass through.
Sausage Roll hits the deck. That jam was called off.
Looks like, yep,
three points for his troubles. Fantastic.
Terry Wherry, has been in touch on the Twitter feed. So sad not to be there today. I pray to the God of Quads for a Welsh victory. The God of Quads. I don't know if we have a God of Quads. We do have an Apex Rex, though, who sits on top of our delightful Spirit of Derby Cup.
And true, that is what the final will all be about. The Men's Roller Derby World Cup, the Apex Rex, made in pewter by our very own Magnus and Bella at rollerderbyjewellery.com.
Indeed. Go and check them out. Some of their work has been absolutely fantastic. We thank them for the trophy they've put to us as well.
Indeed. So currently we have the first Wales timeout in this first half.
We've played about 9.5 minutes so far. Clearly not much between these teams. Scores currently stand Australia 20, Wales 20.
Taking a moment to thank Fastgirl Skates, sponsors of the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. Their knowledgeable staff represents all facets of roller derby.
One thing I've loved about this tournament so far is some of the signs we get to see in the crowds. You can see them flash up on your screen from time to time during our feed. People have gone to a lot of effort for this. It's amazing.
There's some amazing artistic creations out there. So on the jammer line for Team Australia, we have skater number 47, Rogan Josh.
Looks like he's up against 254. It's Reese this time for Team Wales. Oh, yep, I think that's going to be a multiplayer block call. They were just holding him back with a link. Clearly didn't do too much for Jones. Confidence, though, he's up straight away and through for lead jammer.
Rogan Josh has emerged and is now on his initial pass.
I hear his name, it makes me hungry. Reese doing again. Jones, the smart jamming just through, protects his own score. He could try for another lap, get more points onto the board. There's no point. You've got four, protect it, keep a clean sheet at the back, move on to the next jam.
Okay, so regarding Reaper 666 from Team England, he is currently gone for an x-ray after a fall during the England-France game. We here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup wish him the best of luck and hope for a speedy recovery.
Indeed, we thank all our medical team here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup for all the work they've put in. They're having a few injuries to skaters, but they're on in the blink of an eye helping themselves.
This is all due to the good work provided to us by the GBEMS crew working the atonement for us. So, we currently have Skate Pilgrim on a power jam for Team Australia. The mechanic going to the penalty box.
Takes a seat down. Just a bit of clarification between the jam referees there as well to give lead jammer status to Team Australia, confirming that the mechanic hadn't earned it before he served his penalty. Looks like we also have now, unfortunately, another blocker on the way to the sin bin for Team Wales. They're down to just three on track. Only three blockers creates one little extra bit of space for Skate Pilgrim to try and find the gap through.
Hayes being held but is now freed, forming a strong three wall. Assistance from Team Australia. That was Bohemian Slapsody Richie taking Hayes to the inside.
Clark and Roll Call now trying to work together. Roll Call tries to bowl Clark into him and force Skate Pilgrim off track, but he keeps himself on the inside line. The mechanic. Oh my goodness, can that man skate? He appears from nowhere, right on the outside. He's got a huge smile on his face, and quite rightly so.
That apex was so huge, he wasn't even sure himself that he'd actually cleared the line and looked to the referee for approval, and he got a good thumbs up.
I think he just likes to get approval from everyone from things like that, and I don't blame him. Cannot blame the man.
So next up, jamming for Team Australia, we have Sausage Rolls going up against Meredith for Team Wales.
These two have paired off quite a bit so far already in this bout. They seem to be doing a good rotation of jammers between both teams. Sausage Rolls takes it to full effect through for lead jammer for Team Australia. Meredith still struggling, but he's now cleared and completes his initial pass now too.
Sausage Rolls being given a friendly channel through on the outside, then decides to call off the jam, denying Meredith any points there.
Good communication from the Team Australia bench to their skaters on track as well. They're keeping an eye on the position of the Wales jammer at all times and communicating that back to their skaters on track. Sometimes on track, they're not going to have time to see everything that's going on around them. So instead, that's what we've got the bench there for. Luckily, they've got voices.
And they're having to use those voices over today's crowd.
Honey Reduction now has been in contact with us on the Twitter feed. She's saying, go Wizards, you shall not pass. I apologize, it's Honey Revolution, not Honey Reduction. I think my eyes are starting to go along with my voice now. I'm slowly falling apart piece by piece. I came here a whole man, I'm going to leave just a leg.
I think that's what's been beautiful about the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. It really has been more than a competition. It's been a festival in its atmosphere. It's been fantastic to be here. And we're thankful for all you fine people at home watching us as well.
The crowds throughout every single bout have been absolutely amazing, making as much noise as they possibly can. Right now, it looks like Team Wales are trying to make noise for Ashton to get through. It works, and he takes lead jammer for Team Wales.
Rogan Josh being recycled to the back of the pack there by Hayes.
Strong, effective blocking again from Team Wales. As soon as they get that jammer off, they recycle, split back, and force the Australia jammer as far back as humanly possible.
Two very strong walls, proving difficult for both jammers. The pack being stretched out.
It's being split. Team Australia trying to bridge with a man just in the middle. Multiplayer block called on one of the Australia blockers, unfortunately allows Ashton to go through for 5 points. One of the issues that we've identified in numerous games for this is just how difficult it can make if you're committing just these little penalties. Losing just one skater off track can make all the difference in how you defend.
And so here we are with 16 and a half minutes left in this first half. And look at our scores. Currently we have Team Wales on 34, Team Australia on 38 points. This is extremely close roller derby. I love it.
This is exactly what we thought would happen in the build-up to this. Both these teams very, very evenly matched. But Team Wales are relatively new to the realm of men's roller derby. They've only been skating together for a matter of months now. It's been less than a year. They had their debut just a few months ago, early February, against Team England. I mean, to be now at the stage where they're competing for a trophy at the World Cup is amazing.
Skate Pilgrim takes lead jammer.
Looks like Jones still trying his hardest to work his way through that two-man wall at the front, which has now become three-man wall. They're just towering around him. Does his best to work through, though, as a penalty called on the pivot for Team Australia. Skate Pilgrim, smart, sees Jones just coming up behind, call the jam off, protect your back line. Yeah, we've got a massive time difference between some of us, between obviously our live feed going out here and to where those are in Australia who I believe are tuned in watching this game in Perth right now. Perth, I get there eventually. It's 11:20 p.m. on the Sunday, and in Sydney, it's actually 20 past 2 in the morning. Wow.
Literal time travelers, it's amazing.
I was going to say, some of these are watching this yesterday. It's crazy.
So we have the mechanic going up against Sausage Rolls.
Sausage Rolls keeping himself low. It looks like one of the outside pack referees spotted something the jam ref didn't. They've relayed it back in now. It's a back block on Sausage Rolls. He's on his way to the penalty box.
Mechanic holding his face seems to have picked up a slight injury, but he's confirmed it to referee Reaver that he's fine and he's returning, recycling to the back of the pack.
He's probably got a lot in his toolbox to keep himself fit and healthy for this one. Slight injury to the eye, doesn't saw him spotting a gap.
I mean, the mechanic is an extremely physical jammer, but he's not. You get big jammers, and I like to say that their style is blamming, but yeah. No, he's an extremely agile skater as well.
He's of a similar power stance to El Talon from Team Canada.
That's a
he's
really
got a
good
similar
comparison,
style, but he's a smaller skater. He's agile and he's quick.
Speaking to Statman Roush about some stats for this game, if anything, the number 4 and 5 cities that are tuning in with the most people watching are actually Melbourne and Brisbane, and Cardiff is the number 10 city with the most people watching currently as we speak, so that is fantastic stuff.
I think Devil May Claire may be one of them. She sent us a tweet saying, wow, the mechanic. Clearly he's got a few fans, not just in the audience, but at home watching as well. Sausage Rolls through for another point, 4 points, sorry, on the board for Team Australia. Looks like 1957 Spew is on his way to the penalty box now. 3 points on the board for Team Australia at the end, another 4 for Team Wales as well. Our scores now looking even closer than they did earlier. Australia 49, Team Wales 48. There really isn't much to separate these two teams.
How many time really is going to tell on this one, it seems. Now, fresh up as a jammer for Team Australia, we have skater number 57, Stevens.
Up against a Meredith, that's FE26 for Team Wales. Meredith forced off by the final blocker for Team Australia, recycles him back in. Meredith takes no time, wastes none at all, back on track, straight in behind the blocker who took him off and takes lead jammer.
Stevens struggling a little bit at, behind the pack there. He's taken off outside the track and is recycling back.
And just as number 75 for Australia, Justin Credible, comes back on from the sin bin, collides with the back of Creighton Griffiths. Stevens has now gone through the pack by the looks of it. Meredith takes a big hit and a big spill at the end from Justin Credible. Got no choice but to call the jam off.
Just before this next jam, we'd like to tell you about Green Monster Roller Sports. All new, visit us today at grnmnstr.com. Next up, we have Ashton for Team Wales going up against Skate Pilgrim for Team Australia.
This has clearly been an exciting bout so far. Derby Dolly can't take the excitement, and Wrexham Rejects are screaming for their Welsh boys. Ashton doing his best to keep you cheering at home as he goes through and takes lead jammer once more for Team Wales.
Hayes keeping Skate Pilgrim recycled to the back of the pack.
Strong four-man wall for them. They're using that, I believe it's called the Fat Controller-style defensive wall. One turned round and facing, guiding his other three blockers, keeping them in track and making sure they're... Oh! Well, they can try all they like. They're not going to do much to hold back Skate Pilgrim when he skates like that. There are some jammers and skaters in these bouts that can do things on eight wheels that I would struggle to do in flats.
Next up for Team Wales, we have Jones going up against Sassage Rolls for Team Australia. Jones with an immediate hit to Sassage Rolls, but Sassage Rolls pivots and turns round on the outside and emerges as the lead jammer, but he has been chased down viciously by Jones.
Jones has some of the fastest moving feet I have ever seen when it comes to skating. They cross over so quickly. He crosses steps out, cross step out. It's amazing. Fast pack being kept up by both as well. They're trying to charge through. Jones, unfortunately, not quite quick enough to get any points on the board for Team Wales there, but three on the board for Australia. There are some back in Australia, like Awiko, who are saying the Wizards World Cup pajama party is loving the commentary and close action.
Thank you very much. And also, if you're having a pajama party, then please look us up on Instagram under MRDWC. Share your photos of yourself enjoying the cup, whatever you are, wherever you're wearing and wherever you are, and they might make it onto our stream. Thank you.
Mechanic now back on track with the star on his head, as is the Skate Pilgrim. Down the inside line as quick as you like, takes lead jammer for Team Australia.
That inside line was free as a bird, so he just ran to the lead jammer status.
Sometimes you don't need wheels when you've got toe stops. Once again, just a massive gap seems to be left on the inside line there from Team Wales. I'm not sure they were aware of where Skate Pilgrim was on the track. They turned around to see him. Too late, he was gone. Jammer close to jammer as they try and start this one off. It's Sossars, Rolls and Meredith.
It's looking a little bit intimate.
They seem to like each other. Sossars, Rolls looks like he's leaning in, almost like he's going to set off straight away and push Meredith. He doesn't. He skips to the outside instead, but comes into the back of a strong two-man Wales team. Changes his tactic, goes inside. More effective for him that time. Takes lead jammer for Australia, but Meredith is out too. Signals coming from the Team Australia bench, warning them, keep up, keep up, keep the pace up. Sausage Rolls, smart, just passes the last blocker, but knows there's one seated in the penalty box as well. Take the 2 points. Just over 7 minutes left to go in the game now. In the first half, I apologise. Australia on 58, Wales on 62. And it looks like Meredith has made it through first. I apologise, that's Ashton actually, and takes lead jammer for Team Wales.
Fuzz is still thick in the pack, trying to make his way through in his initial pass.
Both teams, we mentioned earlier how strong the defence is going to have to be in games like this. The score reflects it.
Swifty with some great work there. It's almost like the three blockers are actually all turning round in a circular motion to present him with nothing but back.
Yeah, multiplayer block called on number 26, Swifty, though. He now takes his seat into the penalty box. Ashton's through for five more points for Team Wales. Looks like Fuzz is still working hard. He's coming up against just one, then two, then one, then two. Every time he clears one, he thinks he's done, but no. This time he's done it, though, past Clark and roll call to complete his initial pass. Ashton on the floor, as extravagant as you like, hand to head, to hip to head, to hip to head, and calling this one off.
We have a little under 6 minutes left in this first half. Scores as they stand are Team Australia with 58 points and Team Wales with 70 points.
I think that's the biggest point difference we've seen so far in this entire half. The game's been so close, and even now that can change in the space of just one jam. Let's see what Skate Pilgrim and Jones can do for their team in regards to the score in front. Jones up onto his toe stops, runs down the inside line to take leads. Skate Pilgrim still working hard, collides with one of his own blockers who's down on the deck, takes him off track, but he's up. How quick was that?
He is through on his initial pass. Jones comes through.
He's looking. He's
got
watching.
His arms ready.
Pat, 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 pat. Call the jam.
Currently, to give you an idea of the scale of this bout today, this plate final, we have 1,836 viewers in England and 41 international. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Indeed. We hope you're enjoying the action seeing on screen in front of you. Still plenty more to go in this game yet, though.
Sausage Rolls is going to be going head-to-head with the Mechanic.
Sausage Rolls just gains a little bit of a foothold first, and he's through to take a lead for Team Australia.
His blockers are actually able to pass him through their wall backwards, just, and then he pivots around to get that lead jammer status there. That was quite a move.
The Mechanic again right at the end. One last blocker tries to put in a hit on him. He just shrugs it off.
Sausage Rolls was having trouble passing through the Wales wall there, and then decides to call off the jam, denying the Mechanic any points.
Keep a clean sheet for themselves. Twin Towns Derby Brats are loving all the action going on track right now. Can't say I blame them either. This has been quite an enthralling game. Not the highest scoring game we've seen by any means, but the action between both teams within the pack and the jammers when they get through has been top notch.
And if we look at some of the penalties that have been accrued in other games, this has actually been quite a low penalty penalty light bout, I should say.
It definitely has. One of my favourite skater names now jamming for Australia. Looks like your mum is jamming. And he gets through first and takes lead jammer for Team Australia. Got himself low and just powered through the line. Meredith doing his best to try and get through for Team Wales. He's forced off track, recycled back, not too far though. Just in behind where the pack was situated, takes a big block to the side that puts him on the floor.
Your mum accelerates, but he's met by Clements, putting up firm defense.
Your mum just a small nudge in the back as Clements goes down.
Your mum gets through, picking up 5 points. And he should get 10 points for excellent beard.
He has a phenomenal beard. Although, admittedly, his name has called for some really strange calls as this tournament has gone. I don't feel right saying your mum has a great beard. It doesn't seem right to me. He's through again for another 5, though, so he's got that 10 that we thought he would get. Admittedly, it's not for the beard, it's the sheer determination, hard work, and great skating, but... Oh, dear, yep, I think he knows what he's done there.
Yeah, your mom just did a bat block. Your mum is now going to the penalty box. This is a Wales power jam.
Looks like we're getting a star pass situation going on as well now. The pivot's skating along with his star in his hands, trying to find a bit of space to give him time to put it on.
And that is skater number 36, Phillips, for Team Wales.
He's pushing. Just one last blocker to get past. He does. Initial pass now complete for Phillips.
Phillips with a massive smile on his face.
Yeah, we want to know, actually. Now, looking at this, with all this talk of your mum's beard, we want to know who has the best beard. Is it your mum from Team Australia or Badger from Team Sweden? Sorry, you can tweet us online. Just use the hashtag MRDWC and either hashtag your mum or hashtag Badger. Whichever one gets the most will keep you tied with a score. To be fair, it's probably going to be as close a score as we're getting right now on track. Australia 72, Wales on 74. Just over a minute left to play in this first half.
We currently have an official timeout. I believe this will be just to ensure that there are no time problems, that all time has been taken into account.
Okay, it's not just those two have had some fantastic beards, though, throughout this competition. There is actually a link on the MRDWC website. Go to mrdwc.com and you can see pictures of some of the 12 best beards being sported by skaters here at the tournament.
That has been lovingly compiled by our MRDWC blogger, Beat Monkey,
who's done a fantastic job throughout this entire tournament to keep everyone updated. Who may have missed some of the live feeds, not had a chance to watch them back, they can still read over all his posts and keep up to date with the action.
Looks like we're going to return to the action right here. Currently on the jammer line, 14 Wales is Jones. Your mum is still in the penalty box.
Yeah, we got clarification on what that timeout was for. There was just a penalty box error. Red 1 that should have been there, main wearing, not red 17, which was Jenkins. One person who is where he should be right now, there is number 254, that's Jones for Team Wales. Every jammer wants lead, he takes it this time. Little tiny apex jump and a small hop to go with it to put 5 points on the board.
Team Wales blockers with a fantastic assist there in order to move the pack forward, giving him room to get the jump.
One thing that a lot of teams said they worked on in the build-up to this tournament was offensive blocking.
Outside pack ref calls a bat block there on Jones. He is making his way to the penalty box. Your mum back on the track has got a power jam. Out of play called on roll call. Your mum is released.
Quite smart from your mum there. He just waited till out of play was called. Didn't bother engaging roll call, just waits for the call. Roll call has to relinquish his position, allow your mum through. Team Wales are working hard to hold him back. It's roll call and Clark at the front. They're trying their hardest to hold him.
Big hits there, punishing your mum, but no, she has made it out. I've lost the game, haven't I? I've lost the game. Multiplayer block there, called on roll call.
Yep, they were trying to signal his attention, let him know that was going to happen.
But unfortunately, also a cut track for your mum as he returns to the penalty box.
That releases Jones back into play now. He skates around. You can see slowing down, just sizing up what's going on. Signals to his two, three blockers that are left on track. What he wants to do, clearly gave him the right signal. He's straight through. Some good offensive work again from Team Wales blockers. Hayes, Clark and Manwaring working fantastically well together as a team. They just worked. It was almost like the old flying V you used to see in some of the old Mighty Ducks movies as a kid. They attack the back of Team Australia as a three. One at the front, two beside them, punch a hole for the jammer.
Looks like we currently have, I believe, the second timeout that's been called by Team Wales. Oh, no.
Yeah, it was a team timeout.
But no, it's actually been turned into an official timeout.
Yep, they've turned from a team timeout to an official timeout while they just try and clarify something in the middle.
So that means that this first half has not concluded just yet.
Not officially, no. They're running the clock for the official timeout. The NSO is in position, giving us the signal, thumbs or fingers to shoulders.
But still an amazing first half with Team Australia on 77 points, Wales on 84.
7 points of a difference in one half. That is possibly the tightest first half of Derby I've seen all weekend. Both these teams are putting on a fantastic spectacle of men's roller derby.
Today, our penalty box is sponsored by the Quad Skate Shop, Europe's original brick and mortar roller derby equipment supplier. Quad Roller Skate Shop has the best selection and most stock of any store on the continent, with excellent consultation services only a fellow skater could provide. We've got all your needs covered, and we love this game.
As do we, and as does everyone here at the MRDWC. Fans, skaters, officials, and all support staff alike.
I literally think we've been spoiled by this event. There has been some absolute top-notch roller derby on display. And of course, you can watch these games back by going to mensrollerderbyworldcup.com.
Yep, definitely worth checking out. I mean, I know, obviously, from being involved with the announce team, keeping an eye on these games, you don't get to see everything at a time. We've got two tracks running. There's obviously the Roller Derby City track. We've got the Quad Skate Shop track behind us. There's a game still going on live there. There's so much action to take in, so it's great to take use of the archive footage you can see online. I mean, we are literally watching some of the best men's skaters in the world taking part in a tournament here in the UK.
I mean, something to say about both these teams is that they fully prepared for this event. Actually, an interesting fact is both teams played their regional rival. You had Team England and Wales, and then you had Team Australia play Team New Zealand.
Yep, one person who's certainly enjoying some of our difficult moments when it comes to commenting. Embroider Truth. We're basically just chuckling every time the announcer says, "Yeah, mum." There we go, we said it again. Now you can laugh. All right, we do our best. We're here to entertain as well as call the action, I suppose.
Can I be honest? There have been some amazing names over the weekend, but there's always something a bit special about your mum. You know what I mean?
I think I'm going to give my favourite for the weekend, though, to Wesley Crusher, purely because of his number 1701. Only Star Trek fans will get that joke. Yeah, it looks like what they had an official timeout for was Wales were challenging a penalty that was called on their jammer in the previous jam, but unfortunately for them, it was an unsuccessful call. The penalty does still stand.
So that means that the official timeout has finished and we are currently into our halftime. I believe we've got 11 minutes to serve as we want to keep these games on schedule.
Yep, they're trying to run them down. We've got about, there or thereabouts, I would imagine. We've still got the second half of this game to go, which we will bring to you after a brief break for about 15 minutes. I think we're going to chuck it to some adverts now, though. Will you enjoy that? I've been Smack Daddy for this first half, joined by the rather fantastic man sitting to my side,
Robert Rodriguez. Thank you very
there
much.
There he goes. We'll be back just shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back here at the exciting second final of the day, Team Wales versus Team Australia. I am, of course, Robert Rodriguez,
joined by half a man, Smack Daddy, in the corner. What a first half we had there. Both these teams fighting really hard. The tie of scores, so close to each other. Wales on 84, Australia on 77. It's not just scores they've been close on. They've been close on a lot of stats through that first half, which we'll run through for you in just a moment. Looks like skaters are on track, ready to get this second half underway with the first jam, and it'll be Jones leading the way for Team Wales.
With Team Australia's jammer, your mum, in the penalty box. So Team Wales will be starting on a power jam.
Yep, it's safe to say Jones pretty effective in the first half. 18 points for himself he racked up in the first half, just on his lonesome. I think he'll be looking to pick up where he left off with the last one as well. You can see he's just got his eyes on the back of the blockers. He's looking, drops low at the signal from the NSO. Quick run forward from Team Australia for a pivot line start. Jones into the back, crashes through Fuzz. Pushing hard now at the back of the three-man wall. No pack called. Australian blockers have to yield their position. No such luck though. Jones now on his way to the penalty box for a back block. Ooh, that's going to release your mum to come back into play. Gets the signal from the penalty box timers. Your mum now back in as he approaches the back of the pack around the inside of his own two blockers. Outside line on one, skates. Creepy Octopus around the outside, onto one, skates around and takes lead for Australia.
Jenkins was being goated at the back of the pack there, but he wasn't going to take that for an answer and elbowed his way through. Sorry, used his shoulder, dropped it in and got it through.
Looks like roll call now stuck at the back of the pack. He's trying to work his way around, sees a hole on the outside. Rejoins his two blockers at the front. Your mum knocked down, but back up and through for 5 points. A grand slam in the first jam of the second half for your mum.
Jenkins bringing the pack backwards in order to meet your mum. Big hit there.
But it took your mum down off track. His skate came back on. He's called on a cut track now. That releases Jones back into play. He thought he was released back in, but an illegal procedure went before he was allowed to come back out. He's back seated in the penalty box again now.
We're going to be nearing a situation where we'll have a jamless jam. If your mum picks up another penalty, this jam will be called dead.
Yep, he'll be going in. He'll have to stay there. Jones will be in as well. The jam comes to an end before that can happen, Phil.
2 points picked up on that last pass there by your mum.
Oh, no. Referee's changed his signal and put up three. Looks like our live feed viewers has increased from the first game, I think, though, has it, Cody?
It has indeed. We currently have 2,081 viewers here in England. And internationally, we have 47 viewers. Again, thank you very much for tuning in. With this next jam, we have Skate Pilgrim wearing the jammer panty for Team Australia.
And again, difference, just a little bit of power jam can make. Team Australia have now taken the lead after starting that first jam 7 points behind. They're now a point ahead, 85 to Wales, 84. Skate Pilgrim going to do what he can to increase that now as he takes lead jammer for Team Australia. Into the back of the Wales four-man wall, the three-man wall, sorry, they're just trying their hardest to hold him back. No, it was right, it is four-man wall. It's the jammer who's seated in the penalty box.
Team Australia have taken note that Jones is standing up in the penalty box, so they're looking to bridge him all the way back.
Strong blocking, but Skate Pilgrim somehow manages to hold himself up at the front as Jones comes back in like a rocket. Skips past that last Australia blocker. It was number 75, just incredible, like he wasn't even there.
Jones has cleared the pack now on his initial pass.
Skate Pilgrim sees him coming just as they start down that turn and calls the jam off. Another 10 points put up on the board, and a 9 point, sorry, between Australia there. In the lead by 10, 94 to Wales, 84, with 4 minutes gone of the second half.
Again, at the moment, this game is too close to call in any direction. It's fantastic stuff.
Go for it. Sorry, Quaddy.
Oh, no, if anything, I was just going to say that we've got our next jam of red started now. We've got Sausage Roll for Team Australia. And we've got Meredith for Team Wales.
Yeah, Meredith, he himself managed to put 17 points on the board, just one behind Jones in that first half. Goes through and takes lead. It's another stat that the two teams have been very close on in this first half. Wales took lead jammer 14 times, Team Australia only 10. That shows where the points came from and gave Wales that lead at halftime.
Meredith looking to clear a path through on the inside.
Goes through, puts just a solitary point on the board, but every point counts, especially if you keep a clean sheet on the back as well.
picks up that 1 point and calls off the jam.
Yeah, we've had the Wizards of Oz Twitter account have got in contact with us, asking us to vote for your mum in the beard competition. He is just out in front just now. Even that vote's pretty close just now. We really can't separate these two teams on anything. But your mum is just in the lead with 51.
The mechanic going up against Skate Pilgrim for Team Australia.
Bit of jammer on jammer at the back of the wall. The mechanic tries to squeeze through a small gap. He spots on the outside, changes tactic, comes through the middle instead as the Australia blockers try to force him off on the outside.
Hayes was there, ready to recycle.
Oh!
Scott Pilgrim to the back of the pack.
Apex jump from the mechanic. Unfortunately, didn't quite nail it. Just missed and gets called on a cut track. Scott Coughlin, I hope you're enjoying this at home, watching and proud to be a Derby dude.
Skate Pilgrim now enjoying a power jam. Hayes left a pass. He comes through. A full 5 points put on the board. Hayes being called on a multiplayer block, making his way to the penalty box.
Looks like a bit of a breakdown as well. They're not sure, Team Wales, who it was that was called for a multiplayer block.
This has meant that it's just a roll call having to defend.
Yep, Hayes has now been released, though. I'm thinking is back in. Joins up with... Oh, we've got roll call. We can't see just round the referees. Hayes, roll call. And I think it's number 36, Phillips, trying to work hard as a three-man wall.
Roll call with a nice last-ditch effort hit there, but Skate Pilgrim comes through again for another 5 points.
Yep, they were just clarifying what it was. 43, Clark was the one who got called for the multiplayer block, not number three, Hayes. That's why Hayes was released straight back into play as soon as Clark came in. And there's someone else just back in play now, the mechanic back in. Quick swerve stop as he comes into the back of the Australia wall. Your mum now working as a blocker, working as that controller at the front of the Australia wall, pushing his pivot, Flaming Galah, through. Fuzz trying his hardest.
Your mum with a hit there takes the mechanic to the outside.
Think the mechanic felt that one. He's got his hand on his back just now. That was a big hit to knock him off the outside. You can see on your screens there for Team Wales is Jones with a star on his head now, number 254. Creighton Griffiths has the pivot panty back on for Team Wales.
Jones is going to be going up against Sausage Roll for Team Australia, skater number 11. Sausage Roll takes a big swerve to the outside and emerges as lead jammer, but he is being chased down by Jones.
Screamed round the outside, Sausage Roll. Creighton Griffiths just left that little bit of a space.
Two blockers apiece. Sausage Roll again takes another swerve to the outside, gets his hips passed and calls off that jam. 4 points to nothing there to Team Australia.
Yep, Team Australia just been able to open up a little bit of a gap now on the score. Just short of 10 minutes played in this first half. It's 122 to Australia, 90 to Wales. A small gap, still really tight scores.
This next jam will start with Fuzz for Team Australia jamming, going up against Ashton for Team Wales.
Yeah, Ashton, probably Wales' strongest blocker in that first half, racking up 30 points for them out of their 84 in the first half. Yep, Ashton just skipped off the last block and knocked him out of play, but it was an illegal block, which means he did take lead jammer status for Team Wales. Looks like Fuzz has now completed his initial pass through as well. Ashton just looking down the side, watching where Fuzz is on the track.
He's waiting for that call from his bench in order to call off that jam. Some great communication there between Wales and their bench.
It looks like Wales are now going to call a team timeout as well, the first one of this half.
Let this take this opportunity to thank GBEMS. This next jam will be brought to you by GBEMS, the only UK RDA endorsed medical team. Their services have been invaluable this weekend.
Tell you one thing I do think is fantastic to see. We mentioned the crowds earlier on and how supportive they've been of their teams on track throughout this whole weekend. But it's not just their own teams that they're supporting. right now, although we're watching Australia and Wales on track, we've got supporters from Team England, Power of Scotland guys are here. There's fans from pretty much every team. I'm pretty sure we've probably got some Team Canada people still floating around as well. Of course, they'll be taking part in the final later on against Team USA.
Indeed, that will be for the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. This game, however, is for the plate. Something I also did see in the crowd earlier was actually Zorro from Team Ninja Pan. He was actually wearing a Southwest Silos t-shirt.
Fantastic.
Really nice to see.
Zorro probably got the biggest reaction from anyone from this entire weekend when he thanked the crowd for all their support. It was brilliant.
Big hit there by Skate Pilgrim. Takes Meredith to the outside, but himself now having trouble and being taken to the inside. Meredith picks up a lead jammer.
Yeah, he saw the gap around the outside. Too much concentration on protecting that inside line. He left the outside open. Meredith took advantage. Sees the same gap again around the outside. Goes through for 5 points. It's a power jam now for Team Wales. Looks like Skate Pilgrim has taken his seat in the penalty box. Let's see what Meredith can do for Team Wales now.
Some amazing blocking there by Team Wales as they're blocking Your Mom, using him as a goat.
Oh, Your Mom just went for a big block at the end. Just missed it though. Meredith kept his balance and managed to slide around the outside. Meredith just goes for a quick spin, back comes in towards the Australia pack. Your Mum now working hard at the front. He's just a one-man blocking machine, trying to hold Meredith back as long as he can. Power jams like this that can make all the difference for Wales, clawing back that small points difference between the two.
Skate Pilgrim back on track, but he's looking to go against a four-strong blocking team by Team Wales.
Yeah, the Team Australia there just tried to throw the old cut track fake for Meredith and throw him all the way back, even though he had already passed them on track as ahead. So many skaters, just to play safe, will go behind every single blocker on track just to make sure they don't cut. And Main Whirling doing his best to get these Team Wales fans riled up and making as much noise as possible. Yeah, see, now Wales again, just that difference on that power jam. They've clawed the points difference back to just 8 points. 122 to Australia, 114 to Wales as Jones takes the line for them now.
Team Australia choosing to rush the pivot line in order to open up a gap.
Paid off big time for them. Sossar's rolls reeling round the outside and takes lead. Jones skips past a block right at the back from number 505, Son of Skating for Australia.
Sossar rolls, gets the hint, calls off the jam, preventing Jones from picking up points. 2 points on the board for Team Australia.
Jones is so quick coming in and out of those turns. You just lose him as soon as you blink. Looks like we've got Ashton now, I think. Yep, Ashton, 2-8, 2-8, jamming against Fuzz for Team Australia.
Again, Team Australia using the pivot line in order to break up the pack. Fuzz caught behind the four wall.
Ashton takes advantage, goes through and takes lead again for Team Wales.
Ashton stuck at the back of the pack. He's trying to edge through. He gets taken to the inside and he recycles himself back.
All the way in behind, just as we say with him going behind all the blockers.
Low block called, it seems.
Yeah, Fuzz with a low block, meaning he's now got to take a seat in the penalty box. We've got a power jam situation for Ashton.
And this is exactly what Team Wales needs at this point.
Yeah, we're almost halfway through this second half. If Wales can claw back the points difference now, give themselves a boost going into the final quarter of the bout.
Clements there with an assist to try and get Ashton through.
Stevens was trying his hardest to hold him back, but Ashton just kept pushing, forced the out of play, goes through for another 5 points and a grand slam. This time, Mainwaring's on his way to the penalty box for a multiplayer block, spills as he goes in, but takes his seat safely.
We currently have a tied game at 1-2-4 for each Australia and Wales.
But I think Ashton's just gone through for another five for himself. That takes us to 1-2-9 to 1-2-4. Wales were almost 30 points behind. In fact, they were 32 points behind just a couple of jams ago. Power jams make all the difference. Ashton sees the jammer standing as Fuzz stands in the penalty box. Smart. Call the jam off so you can start this one off on a power jam situation.
And the person who will take that power jam situation is the mechanic.
If you're going to have anyone from Team Wales starting a power jam, 9 times out of 10, you can guarantee it'll be the mechanic.
You use the right tool for the right job.
Correct. Good bit of communication again from the bench there at Team Wales, realising their pivot is seated in the penalty box. Can't start the jam with the pivot on track. He weeks the panty off his head and throws it to the crowd.
The mechanic truly is devastating. Look at him pushing that four-man wall straight forward.
Fuzz is back on track, though. He's been released from the penalty box.
Hayes quickly waterfalls to the front to try and capture him.
Fuzz came back in. No such luck for Hayes. And Fuzz takes lead jammer for Team Australia as Hayes goes towards the penalty box. Looked like he may have been called for a low block or a direction of gameplay there. The mechanic's still pushing hard at the front of that Wales wall, but they've reformed to a four. Now Clark comes in, tries to create a hole for him.
Big pile up there on the track.
Mechanic, oh no, he's lost his helmet cover off his head. We've now got a legal procedure called on Richie at the back. 3 points put up on the board for Team Australia, but nothing for the mechanic as he cleared through. He had no cover on his head, meaning he can't score points.
That was a tough situation. We've had quite a few situations of that throughout the last 2 days. Yep. I know Team Ninja Pan have fallen foul to it for quite a few times. In fact, in one jam, the Ninja Pan jammer panty was actually stuck on one of Team Belgium's elbow pad on the Velcro.
Oh dear, looks like we've had another score change and lead change again. Australia now back ahead by a point. 1-3-2 to 1-3-1 and up by a lead jammer now as well. The Skate Pilgrim takes it. He's working hard at the back of that Wales wall as Meredith pushes his way through. Straight pass, just incredible to complete his initial pass. Skate Pilgrim Phil clears through for his scoring pass. 4 points on the board for them, 0 for Team Wales. Extends that lead to 5. Looks like we've now got Ashton for Team Wales up against Sossar's Rolls, number 11, who has some of the largest elbow pads I have ever witnessed in the world of men's roller derby. They almost come from his armpit down to his wrist, and they are thick and padded. The man has well-protected elbows. Ooh, couldn't protect his sternum there, though, as he took a big hit and forced him off the outside of the track, but he's so quick. Steps back onto the inside, or the outside line, sorry, and just runs around the Wales wall. Ashton now as well has completed his initial pass. Sossar's Rolls turns around, skates backwards, sees where Ashton is, and smartly calls the jam off.
Team timeout being called by Team Wales.
Yeah, it looks like we have the quads captain from MK Roller Derby cheering on Swifty. That's number 26 from Team Wales. Quick chat being had by the bench and lineup from Team Wales with the skaters on track. The jammer for this one wearing the stars is going to be 254 Jones. Looks like Team Australia are just hugging it out amongst them in the corner, having a nice little chat, getting themselves composed and calm. Try and recover just that little bit of composure that they had.
I think you've hit the nail on the head there. If anything, this game has been extremely calm. I know we were talking during the halftime that both these teams throughout the last 2 days have put up extremely tenacious physical games.
Yeah.
Both of them have been extremely calm and relaxed all the way throughout the first half, and it has extended into the second half. And it's meant that we've had such an exceptional game, a very, very close game.
Indeed. I mean, neither team has been overly penalty heavy in this game. Despite, I mean, there's some massive hits getting put in. The defense being played by both teams has been so strong, but clean at the same time. I mean, little fouls are being called, and little things, cut tracks, back blocks as jammers come in and crash through.
Yeah.
It's not through any sort of lack of knowledge about what they're doing. It's just little mistakes. But even then, they're keeping them limited. Australia again now running forward for a pivot line start. Jones round the outside of his own wall to crash into the back. He's starting to push.
Skate Pilgrim falling foul of Crichton. Crichton Griffiths' hips.
Oy, and he's forced off on the outside by, I'm not entirely sure, I missed who it was. Couldn't quite catch him around the corner. Looks like Clement. Skate Pilgrim now, though, has cut track. He's on his way to the penalty box. Meaning Jones has a power jam for Team Wales. Strong blocking forces him off. Only 4 points for him, though, because one of the Australia blockers that he passed had gone down, come off track with him. He seems to favour that outside line as he comes in. He skates around the outside, drops his shoulder, and just cuts inside.
That's exactly what I was about to say. If anything, it's taking the harder path. Obviously, if you go from the inside line, you're covering less distance.
Yep.
But if anything, he likes an outside line.
You tend to find whenever the walls and packs are up near one of the turns, you have to come at them from the outside to try and take that inside line. Jammers love an inside line. If you're going to try an apex jump, you have to come from the outside. Give yourself momentum, build up, and go for it.
Jones firing up the crowd before he tries again to get this pass underway.
Indeed, and once again, a difference that a power jam makes with a lead change score-wise again. It's now 145 to Wales, 140 to Australia.
Tell me if I'm wrong, but I believe that's the fourth lead change we've already seen within, 10 minutes?
About 10 minutes of the half passes. I mean, we're almost 20 minutes through the entire half itself now, but in the last 10 minutes, as you say, we've now had a 10-point lead for Australia been switched right round in the space of essentially one power jam. 19 points scored in that last jam brings us back to a 10 point lead now for Wales, 150 to Australia's 140. I think we're getting just a quick official timeout now, possibly an official review actually being called.
As soon as we have an update on that official review, we will keep you fully informed. In the meantime, though, the Men's Roller Derby Association would like to wish all the teams competing in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup the best of luck this weekend. The MRDA is the international governing body for Men's Flat Track Roller Derby and wants you to join them in the growing world of Men's Roller Derby. For more information about joining and the benefits of being part of the MRDA, visit them at mensrollerderbyassociation.com or send inquiries to info@mensrollerderbyassociation.com.
They are going to be inundated with emails and requests after this weekend. The crowd now keeping themselves amused during this official review, giving themselves a Mexican wave as it goes round and round the outside of the track.
Now, of course, if you're enjoying and listening, drop us a few quid, dollars, lotty, yen, whatever comes to hand, using the link on the broadcast page. So this is going to be split 50-50 between the organisers of the Men's Roller Derby World Cup to cover expenses and teams' travel funds.
I mean, some of the teams have had to spend a lot of money. I mean, Argentina, Japan, Australia have had to spend so much money to travel from where they are to come over here for this tournament. The fact they've been able to do it shows the support that they've received from their fans, from, you know, support, charity, fundraisers, anything at all just to send their teams over here. If you want to help out as well, by all means, go to the links that Cody just gave you there and donate some money to it. It's very much appreciated.
A lot of these teams before the Men's Roller Derby World Cup had all set up Kickstarters to help them get here. So it's truly for the love of roller derby that they're here today. And for that, we are truly, truly thankful.
Now we see this is the game now to define the winners of the plate for the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. The main final for the Spirit of Derby Cup will be played out between Team England and Team USA later on. In fact, just a couple of hours' time, I think 5 o'clock, that one will be coming on. All the times, etc., can be found on mrdwc.com. you get a list of all the teams playing, the times they'll be on track, and when you should be online to tune in to the live feed.
We're currently just being updated as to the nature of the official review. As soon as we have that information, we will pass that along.
In the meantime, don't forget, get yourselves online to Instagram. We still want some of your selfies. There were some portrayed on the live feed during the interval between first half and second half. You can look them up under MRDWC. Share your photos of you enjoying the World Cup wherever you may be. You never know, it could be your face showing up on the screen next. Just use the hashtag MRDWC.
And please also tweet us what you're doing, and if you're holding a men's roller derby World Cup party, we want to know about it.
Indeed.
Any shout outs, please send them to us. And just a reminder, that was hashtag MRDWC.
Yeah, we found out now, we do have the information. Turns out Australia had challenged the cut track call on Skate Pilgrim. An unsuccessful challenge, though. The call does still stand.
Skate Pilgrim is now back on track, and he's trying to force his way through a three-wall with a fat controller at the front.
Sure enough, though, starts with a power jam situation. Originally for Team Wales, it was the mechanic on track. He's taken advantage and takes lead jammer for Team Wales, too. He hops, he skips, he jumps, but he charges through. He's now up against a strong four-wall.
The mechanic gets the 2 points, calling off the jam. Fantastic defense there by your mom.
That just gives them a chance to extend that lead by another three now, actually, they put up. It's now 153 to 140.
13 points difference with just under 10 minutes to go.
Yep, Leanna Land at home watching this one will be cheering them on. She said, go Wales. They're certainly going now, but so Sossar rolls. Going as fast as he can into lead jammer status for Australia. It looks like Meredith just losing his footing a bit as he comes around the turn there, but his initial pass has now been completed. Sossar rolls. Oh, what footwork from Meredith. Swings around, transitions around the outside of the Australia blocker.
Sossarge rolls, goes around Team Wales on one skate using the inside line and calls off the jam as he does, picking up 4 points.
We want to say a big thank you to Rory for sending us in his selfie. He's sitting watching the Australia versus Wales game. He has sent us a picture of himself on the sofa with the cat. The cat is loving a bit of MRDWC just now. It's brilliant. Rory himself is chilled out, laying back. The cat's excited. The cat's screaming at the camera going, come on, we want to know who the cat's cheering for.
Skate Pilgrim for Team Australia going up against Ashton for Team Wales. Both are currently emerged in a thick pack there.
Yeah, we've had confirmation at least that Rory is definitely supporting Australia. I think the cat may well be too.
And it is Ashton who has emerged as your lead jammer.
Yep, his support's right here in the crowd, giving him a big cheer as he breaks through the front of the Wales wall.
Roll call, currently edging out Skate Pilgrim, recycling him all the way to the back of the pack.
He's forced about 20 feet back from where his own blockers were. They're not going to be able to give him any help by getting through that Wales pack as they try and hold Ashton up at the front.
Rogan Josh working on Ashton. Ashton taken to the inside. Great hit there by Monkey Nuts from Team Australia.
We've now got number... Oh, I missed whose number that was.
89, that 89. Is Trinder. Trinder going to the penalty box.
Yep, he takes a seat down. He's there for a minute. Skate Pilgrim with a nice spin around the outside, but a huge hit once again from Jenkins. Puts him on the floor, forces him all the way back. And now we've got roll call going to the penalty box. Looks like a forearms major called on roll call. Jenkins is having a whale of a time out there. Skate Pilgrim's having no luck whatsoever. Fist pump celebration from Jenkins as he puts Skate Pilgrim off and tag again. Oh no, Skate Pilgrim, he got knocked and sent flying. He thought he'd kept himself in track. Jam referee sees a cut track and sends him to the penalty box. Closely followed by Hayes now taking a seat, but no. No, it looks like Skate Pilgrim's call was actually reversed. The cut track was turned back into a no pass, no penalty. The referee signaled it himself, meaning a timeout Australia, just to try and get clarification and work out exactly what was going on there.
We currently just have just over 6 minutes left in this final half of this second final of the day for the plate.
Yeah, Wales currently leading 167 to Australia's 148. Still, I mean, literally just one power jam of a difference. That's all it takes, one lead jammer situation for Australia, and they could be back in this in the blink of an eye.
I mean, we've seen a lot of exciting games. We've also seen a few blowouts, 0 points scored, but this game has been tete-a-tete. It has been so close all the way throughout.
This is the kind of action that people tune in to see. It's been a fantastic game so far. I wish they could go on longer, but they do have just 6 minutes and 11 seconds left to go. Team timeout's not officially been called as over yet, but the skaters are back on track, ready to go. They've got Jones now jamming for Team Wales. I think he's up against number 11. Yep, it's Sausage Rolls for Team Australia. Whistle goes, jam time is away. Sausage Rolls away quicker though. Low stance goes round the outside of the Team Wales blocker. He was so low you couldn't have hit him if you tried. Apex jump on the second one. This man is on fire. Sausage Rolls giving it everything to claw Australia back into this one. And he's got a better opportunity now as Jones cuts track on the outside and goes to take a seat in the penalty box. Sausage Rolls now on a power jam for Australia.
Team Wales are going to be supported by Roll Call. He has returned to track. He's currently being goated at the back of the pack and he's fighting it out to return to his teammates.
Takes a hit though, Rokoff forced down to his knees just as Sausage Rolls comes back in. He gets forced off, but unfortunately it's via the means of a multiplayer block from Phillips. He's now taking a seat in the penalty box as Sausage Rolls puts up another 5 point grand slam for Australia.
We currently have had another lead change. We currently have Australia on 168 to Wales 167.
But then again, he puts another five on, turns that to 173 to 167. Sausage Rolls just swings off the back of Hayes onto his toe stops. Thought he was going to knock him off, but he somehow stayed on and just jinked and shimmied his way down the side.
Team Australia edging Roll Call to the back of the pack.
Jones now been released from the penalty box. He's back in play. Sausage Rolls complete another scoring pass. Again, so low around the outside. How does the man do it? You swing to hit him, and before you know it, he's not even there.
Jones is powering past and gets past your mum.
Yeah, but your mum's away for blocking out a play. Hey, that rhymes.
And Sausage Roller passes round the hips of Roll Call, calls off the jam.
Wow, that was a massive point swing. Team Wales now on 167. One power jam of a difference. We said it just before that jam started. It's like Australia knew what was coming. They now lead by 193 to 167. It's a 45 point of a difference. No, 46, I apologise. No. That was a 45-point jam. I do apologise. I'm getting too excited. I'm getting caught up in the game. I read things. I don't know what I'm reading. The mechanics now in for Team Wales.
Skate Pilgrim emerges as lead jammer for Team Australia.
Yep, just a blocking out of play. It looks like called at the back there on Longworth. Five more points put on again from Skate Pilgrim. The mechanic still trying, working so hard, he crashes into the back of Spew. It looks like a combination of the two just trying to hold him up. I think that's Spew, and it looks like AJ Stevens trying the hardest to hold him. Mechanic completes his initial pass. Now throws to Skate Pilgrim. Just as he comes to the back, calls it off. See, great derby spirit there. AJ Stevens worked his hardest to hold the mechanic back. The mechanic fought hard to push him through, but still, as the jam comes to an end, a high five between the two to say, job well done.
In fact, as Stevens was holding the mechanic there, when the mechanic was able to get past his hips, he was actually applauding him and gave him a point saying, yeah, I'm applauding you. That was some great effort there, son.
Exactly. We've now had Australia have hit the 200-point barrier. 200 to Wales, 167. And Sausage rolls back on jamming for Australia now against Meredith. He takes lead jammer for Team Wales.
Meredith getting low, getting his shoulder in there, literally fighting his way through to get that lead jammer status.
Oh no, it looks like we've had a contract called on Sausage rolls on the outside. Meredith has himself a power jam. Can he claw back the points for Team Wales?
Less than 2 minutes on the clock and less than a minute and a half in this jam.
Oh, strong block forces Meredith down and off. No pass, no penalty, though smart from Meredith. He's up, round. Your mum had paused to let him through, and he just took full advantage of it.
Assist there by Longworth.
Yeah, but
Meredith
Longworth
taken to the outside.
Yeah, Longworth had just stepped off track as he did it, though he was blocking out of bounds, unfortunately.
Stevens looking to recycle him all the way to the back of the pack.
Small jink and a dance from Stevens. Knows how far he's forcing Meredith away from his own blockers. Oh, strong blocking from Jenkins, though. Cuts a hole around the outside for Meredith. Five more points on the board for Team Wales. This is close. Meredith glides around the outside with a goat held at the back. Big push from your mum forces him down and wide, but he keeps himself on track for another five. Meredith is giving his all, trying to do what he can to claw Team Wales back into this.
Sausage rolls back on pack. He's working his way around the outside of the track. Clements with a hit, but he is through on his initial pass.
Meredith, he's working at the back. Oh, Sausage rolls.
Sausage rolls, loses grip and falls down, taking Meredith out.
Went into the back of Meredith's legs, took him down, and it looks like Sausage rolls has been called on a low block right at the end there. One point apiece put up right at the end of that jam.
Official timeout called by head referee Pachinko.
They're just trying to clarify what's going on. Now, obviously, the clock in itself has run down, but they're not sure if timeouts were called in time for them to get another jam into this game or not. We'll wait and see what the officials come back with from that.
This is a truly, truly exciting almost conclusion to the plate final. This is going to be fantastic to see how this swings, if those team timeouts were registered, and whether they will be able to get a final jam out of this game.
I mean, that was a 20-point power jam for Meredith and Team Wales. He clawed it back. Australia now won 201 to Team Wales 187. This, I mean, literally everything rests on what happens coming out of this official timeout. We don't know. Will they get another jam squeezed in? We don't know.
We've got both benches returning to... We've both got captains and bench staff returning.
Yeah.
The referees are having their deliberations.
While they do that, we'll say hi to Skatey Crusham, who's watching this on a 120-inch screen in the pub. Lucky for some, I didn't know pubs even had 100... Didn't even know 120-inch screens existed, to be brutally fair. Butterscotch is also watching the hashtag MRDWC. Good use of the hashtag there on a beautiful day in Philadelphia. Don't rub it in that you're sitting out in the sun watching this on a beautiful day, Butterscotch, but we hope you're enjoying what you're seeing on the track. This has been a truly outstanding final for the plate. You can see both team captains are just hovering round. They're so anxious to see what comes out of this official timeout.
Both teams on their benches all huddled around each other, calming each other, getting ready. A lot of spirit and a lot of sportsmanship going on.
Looks like we're going to get just a little bit more information as to what's happening here.
The crowd keeping in great spirits here. A Mexican wave going all the way around the track.
Yeah, it looks like we're getting clarification now. Team Wales were looking for the low block to be called as an expulsion, we think, on Sausage Rolls, but it looks like the low block call is going to stand just as a low block, so we'll find out in just a moment. We'll get definite confirmation on that for you, but it seems to be that that's the challenge they're looking for. Yeah, we've got clarification now from the officials. They were looking for that low block at the end there from Sausage Rolls as he crashed into the back of Meredith to be called as an expulsion as opposed to a low block. But looks like decision of the referees is the low block call will stand.
I mean, of course, it was a low block in its nature, but it wasn't egregious. Obviously, it looked like Sausage Rolls just lost his footing.
He lost his balance, skated in. Yet there was 1 second left on the clock when that timeout was called, meaning we are going to see one more jam, which is going to start due to that low block call at the end on Sausage Rolls in a power jam situation for Team Wales. And it's Ashton on track with the star panty on his head looking to claw back that difference in a power jam. This is what people want to see. This is Derby at its finest.
Sausage Roll in the penalty box looks at Ashton and gives him the thumbs up.
Looks like your mum also seated in the penalty box, meaning Wales not only starting, or sorry, Australia not only starting a jammer down, but they're starting a blocker down as well. Team Wales only have 3 blockers on track, but they're starting with the jammer. It gives them full advantage going into the start of this final jam.
This is some tense action here. Ashton pumping up the crowd, and this final jam is exactly what the crowd were expecting and wanted.
I think we've got nearly 95% of everyone in the building crowded round the track for this one. So keen to see the outcome. It's been a tight match from first whistle to what will soon be the last. Nothing really between the teams. Lead changes back and forth, back and forth. Drama right at the end here with Sausage Rolls' call at the end. A second remaining on the clock. Timeout called, meaning for that 1 second left, we'll squeeze one more jam in. No.
And here we go. The official timeout ends. We are getting ready for this.
Team Australia run forward. Wales bridge to make sure the pack is created. Ashton comes into the back of Team Australia's wall. He's working hard, but the Australians fighting so hard to hold him back. Ashton takes a spill, knocked to the floor.
He almost looks at the referee to make sure it wasn't a cut. He doesn't want one at this point.
He doesn't. There was no cut track. There was a no pass, no penalty called, which unfortunately means for Ashton, though he does not get lead jammer status. To be fair, I'm not sure how much of a difference it's going to make for this jam. I guess we'll soon find out.
He passes around on the outside and picks up a full 5 points.
Ashton is going to be jamming. Thumbs up to his bench as he goes round. Jamming like a man possessed now. He's tired. It's been a long weekend of Derby. This has been a long, tough game. But Ashton is going to keep pushing until the end.
Sausage Roll standing in the penalty box. If Ashton's going to bring something out the bag, he needs to do it now.
He's got through for another 5-point pass, but Sausage Rolls, as you said, is now back in play. He goes through and takes lead jammer. There's a 4-point difference in this. Sausage Rolls calls the jam.
The whole crowd was screaming at Sausage Roll, please call off this jam.
Ashton put 3 points on the board for Team Wales. Would you believe it? Australia 201. Ashton missed the last blocker. Called short, 200 points for Wales. Australia win it by a single point.
Now that is how you win a plate here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup.
Goodness. Wow, just a wow. We could not ask for a better end to a plate final. Two teams who fought it out like mad on the track. Team Australia, lead change with Wales, back forth, neither team deserved to lose, unfortunately one does, your winners of the plate final, Team Australia by 201 points to Wales, 200, wow, Quaddy, wow.
That was a fantastic final jam. That does mean, of course, that Team Australia will take fourth place overall in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup, Wales will take fifth.
It's just amazing, absolutely astounding. We've still got two amazing games of Derby left to go. Stick around for those. Go to mrdwc.com, get the link there for the times of the final. I have been smack daddy in what is possibly the best game of Derby I've seen in a long time.
I definitely have to agree with you, and thank you very much for watching. I have been Robert Quadriguez. Thank you very much. We are now going to throw to...
Oh my goodness, Australia versus Wales, 200 to 201, it looks like, to our feed. I'm guessing from the cheers that those scores have gone official now, meaning that Australia will have won the plate. They take home that piece of silverware. There's still a skate-off going on at the moment between Canada and France to see for third and fourth, but it does mean there's only one piece of silverware left on the line now, Andy.
That's incredible. If the final is at anywhere half as good as the bout we've just seen on this channel, we're going to be in for a treat. Wales just took it right for them. I thought they were going to snatch it. Australia, I mean, they've been the party poopers today. They've beaten Argentina. They've beaten Wales here, very partisan crowd. But Australia have been magnificent today, I have to say. Sausage Rolls was really led from the front. They've been awesome. They really have. They've been great off the track here. They've been great ambassadors. They've come all this way. They've been incredibly sporting, and they've really, really left on the track. I know it must be 2:30 in Sydney in the morning, but wow, that was worth staying up for. And don't go to bed just yet, because of course we've got the final coming up. But that was one of the bouts of the tournament so far.
I couldn't agree with you more. That was absolutely a humdinger. So. Over on the Quad Skate Shop track right now, you can see the tail end of Canada versus France. Canada currently ahead on that track for the third and fourth place playoff. But coming soon to the Roller Derby City track, keep it tuned here and you'll be able to see the first ever Men's World Cup final between Team England and Team USA. It's going to be off the chain. Keep it with us here.